NJ Weedman writes me and says, I am at the trial, and he is a big proponent and advocate of legalizing marijuana, and we've met him 1,000 times. We really like the guy. He says, I'm at the Peditto trial. For a few months, I've given John Peditto pointers, and now I have no doubt the jurors are arguing over whether to rubber stamp the law or utilizing jury nullification. For those of you who don't understand what's going on, explain what's going on, Dennis, with this jury trial.
In a nutshell, John Peditto, Mays Landing resident, grew pot in his backyard, 17 plants. Cops came by and saw it. Maybe somebody told him, I don't know. So they arrested him, charged him with growing marijuana, and he faces up to 20 years in jail. 54 years old, never been in trouble with the law, 52, 54, never in trouble with the law, and now he faces 20 years in prison because he grows a little weed and smokes a little weed himself. And is this the kind of society we want to live in? Now, a lot of people mostly have made up their mind on the marijuana thing.
Right.
Medical and or recreational. That, it's bad. My kids are going to get it. Your kids are going to get it more if it's illegal because there's a black market that makes it accessible to them.
Right. We've heard from many, many listeners who have said when the doctor recommended marijuana for them, you know what? Tell your kid to go get it. Yeah. Don't even try to get in the program.
So, and Bill Spadia, who's on in the morning for Jim these days, had mentioned that once he had kids, he said, oh, yeah, there's a drug problem. We shouldn't make marijuana illegal. Then he saw a case like this. He said this case turned him back around to say, yeah, why is it illegal? It's ridiculous. So we have John Peditto and NJ Weedman on the line here to talk about this, and maybe we'll get your thoughts too. Weedman or John, who am I speaking to?
Well, we're on speakerphone. We're both here.
Hi. How you doing, Weedman? Who wants to start?
Well, I'll let you and John talk, but I tell you what, like, this is great, man. The jury is actually, like, really considering this, and, like, this should have been a 5-minute discussion, but instead it's over a day. They are actually considering jury nullification.
Jury nullification is
where... That's amazing.
They take it into their own hands, and they say, we acquit, not based on the facts and the law, but based on our opinion of what this man did and what he should deserve as a punishment, so we're going to acquit. And if that happens, that's going to be a landmark decision in the state and a landmark case. John, real quick, John, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Our heart goes out to you. You have a family of a wife, children. What's the deal?
Well, I got a girlfriend. She's a lot like a wife. I have one kid. He's in Pennsylvania, and he has suffered from these marijuana laws out there. That's a whole nother story. But, yeah, I have a small family, and they've been here. They're not here today. But
John, how'd you hook up with Weedman? Did he seek you out?
I met him through the coalition, and I met him through the job fair.
Yeah, we went to something together and met a while ago. Yeah. But the whole jury nullification, you know, I could be called jury nullification man. I've been touting jury nullification for as long as I've been touting legalization of marijuana.
Right.
And you remember, this happened to me a couple years ago, and I won the same way. I argued to the jury to say not guilty, despite the fact that I was guilty. And they did find me not guilty. And now, you know, John knew he couldn't sign a piece of paper and walk in jail. He looked to do the same thing.
So yeah. Are you saying
let's pray.
That for
let's
people,
pray that those 12 people, 11 women and one man, let's pray that they hear his message and they vote.
Because if they do, then more and more people will go, hey, what is this jury nullification thing? And with these guys, Weedman and John and all the other people who are listening right now, who are aware of the jury nullification awareness campaign that these guys are into,
right,
then more and more juries will see what this is about.
And it's more about the spirit of the law and what's a punishment that fits a crime. You're not going to have people saying, well, you can do that with murder, too. No, it's not.
Absolutely.
I think most people who believe in legalizing marijuana do not believe in legalizing murder. John, how did you get caught? What was a neighbor snitched on you? It was obvious had plants blown around the front yard. How'd this happen?
No, I was out in the heart of the Pine Barrens, and we just ran into each other. You know, I go there a few times every summer, and they just happened to be out there, and we just ran into each other. It was really a very quiet event. It wasn't any kind of excitement.
So you're going out to the Pine Barrens to check on your marijuana plants. The cops are already out there?
Yes.
And they say, what are you doing right in front of your plant? Where were they?
Well, as soon as I walked up to the plants and started looking at them, they just... yelled voices out of the woods. They scared the hell out of me, and that was it.
They scouted it from the sky, and they were waiting for you?
You know, they'll never tell you that.
Yeah, that's what happened. Come on.
Yeah, they don't want you to know.
Well, they're hanging out. They were looking for squirrels, and they happened to find John.
They were hunting.
They spotted it from the sky. They spent millions of dollars burning fuel and spotting it from the sky, and then millions of man hours and dollars waiting in the woods for little John Peditto to come by and pick his plants. Ridiculous.
You got that right. I'll tell you one thing, though, that most of my jurors, almost all of them, are completely on board with medical marijuana, and I got that through sidebar, which I was able to get because I'm defending myself.
Right.
And they're all on board with that, and I was very thankful for that, and I'm just trying to connect those dots between medical and recreational, because it's you know, a large majority of the people don't necessarily say they're using it for medical purposes, and I'm hopefully this jury... I've been able to make that connection. I've been working hard to do that. But they're all on board with medical, and that's a good thing.
Are you saying you use it for, you know, high blood pressure or to relax or to...
No, when I come home from work, instead of drinking alcohol, I smoke a joint. That's it. That's what I use when I come home from work. I explain that to the jury. So, you know, if I'm different in any way, it's that I'm more or less just saying I use it when I come home from work to relax instead of getting drunk.
Like you have a glass of white wine, and Listen.
Now, was that just luck? How did the jury composition turn out that way?
You have to dismiss jurors as you go. You get 10 dismissals each in the prosecution, and it's more of a dismissal process, which leaves 12 remaining jurors. So you're not picking them, you're just dismissing them, and then whatever's left after.
Let's get as much light shed on this as possible, because this is really important.
Doesn't the state pick their own people too?
Yeah.
I mean, they're going to dismiss people also.
So as I'm thinking, John, who's representing himself, picking and choosing and eliminating and defending himself against the state of New Jersey.
That's amazing that he even made any headway. And the fact that, as Weedman wrote me in his letter, how can they put this guy in prison knowing others are making money and being treated with it?
I'm looking at 36 years.
John, hang on the line, John. We got a break for traffic. I want to talk to you some more and take some calls on this too. We're talking to John Peditto, who faces 36 years in prison for growing some weed plants. 11:19. We're talking about this case of John Peditto, who's caught growing some marijuana, not in his backyard, but in the pines, and then the cops probably spotted it from the air. Waited for him, so they had a helicopter, the fuel, the binoculars, the whole thing. Maybe it was night vision, whatever. And then they go, okay, let's send five guys into the woods to stand there all day getting ticks, waiting for some guy who lives in an apartment in Mays Landing to look for his weed plants. Let's descend upon him and put him in jail for 36 years because he's growing a plant that the pharmaceutical companies don't want to be legal because they'll lose some market share. How do you like that? And that's the truth. That's the fact. Those are the facts. And if you want to comment on it, 1-800-283-101.5. Maybe if you want to call and say, hey, you grow it and give John tips on how not to get caught. John, are you still there?
Yeah, I can use those tips.
Yeah. I'm not a super religious person, but I want everybody to pray for you that those 12 people get the message and find it in their hearts to do the right thing and acquit you of... And not send you to jail. It's a pity. What kind of work do you do, if you don't mind me asking, John?
No, I'm a full-time photographer, primarily.
One of those artsy-fartsy types, I see.
Everything from weddings to photojournalism. Not so much anymore, because they have an online... it's a long story. They've destroyed my career, these courts, in short. And that's a different story, but...
Oh, God, that sounds like an interesting story. We got to hear that one day, how they did that.
No, I can tell you all about it. I will say this. It's been a hung jury twice already, and that is exactly what I'm trying to get here. And they're still... They keep sending them back in there to deliberate, and it's just unnerving. It's over, it's not over, it's over, it's not over. So they're back in there again.
Deliberating right now.
Yeah.
All right. Will you let us know?
Meanwhile, your life hangs in the balance. Yeah, you better call us.
Will you let us know what happens later in the day, please?
Absolutely.
Or
if I'm not here, Ed will fill in for me.
Or if not, Ed Forshawn, who's NJ Weedman. John, good luck to you, sir. Thanks for your time.
Thank you so much.
I think he will be here, man. I'm very confident that you're going to be found not guilty.
All right.
Hung jury.
Call us back, Ed, okay?
Yep.
Thank you. Appreciate that very much. All right, Brian's